All right, so just pulled up to a no cooling call. I think they said the upstairs unit is not cooling. So I'm gonna go ahead and see if we can get some footage.
What's going on?
So yesterday, the regular unit was working, right? So yesterday, around 4:30 or so,
okay.
I don't know how long I've been going on, how I've been going on, and I came, the AC wasn't cool, and the cool was not inside.
Upstairs, downstairs.
So, of course, the upstairs unit was keeping it in control, somewhat out of control. And I came out here and I noticed this unit, it didn't seem like it was condensing. It didn't seem like the condenser was running. And the fan was just like, almost like, just free spinning, like air,
Okay.
Very little, you know, a couple times a minute.
Oh, yeah.
So I thought, okay, what's going on? I turned it off, turned everything off. I removed the wrong capacitor because sometimes that's kind of like the first go-to. So I took that and I took that for a shop. I was like, maybe my wrong capacitor is bad. It's not going to be good. I was like, really, really, really good. It was off. It was free. So I said, well, let me just have you come and check because who knows, I mean, if it's pretty good in the afternoon.
Yeah.
It's probably going to be 2 days.
That's what they told me. They said maybe the fan is going on.
Yeah.
Should I turn it off?
No.
Okay.
So we got a customer here. He said that he came out yesterday and the fan was barely spinning. And so he took the capacitor to someplace and they checked it for him and the capacitor read the correct amount of microfarads. So he said when he came back, he put it in, put it back in, and it started running fine. So I think he probably got a motor that's going out. I'm gonna check the microfarad too. So this microcompressor right here, I got 14.2. This is the fan. Got 1.2. I'm trying to monitor that fan. Got 1.2 amps. Rated for 1.5. I'm at 1.4 right now. It's kind of jumping up and down. So I just turned it back on. Let it run for a while. See what it's doing. I think that thing is seizing up. They said the compressor was on, but the fan was barely turning. I'm gonna verify the correct microfarads myself. Like I said, that he took it up to some shop and check it. This unit is happened. 2012 or 07. Sometimes I forget the nomenclature for the unit. I think the first number on the building is 2012. Feel the bearings with the stiff. If you're looking on film, you may see the fan going real slow because it's just drained for a second. It seems like it's running normal to me. Maybe. Take it off, I want to feel the bearings you have filled in, and take some faster also. This and that is the common. It's the fan. Like it rated for 70.5. Yeah, I got 4.9 on the fan. That's good. Let's go ahead and check the compressor while we're at it. Not going over the rater. So this capacitor is good. still gonna say 59. And the purple off. So we got the brown, purple, and black. I think those are the only three wires. Careful with these Goodmans taking the top off. Play in it, but not too bad. Motor kind of hot, and like I said, not over amping it. I'm gonna speak with the homeowner, see if he want to replace this motor. Or we can play it by ear, because it's not over amping. Is good. So I'm see what he want to do. Since it's older, almost 10 years old, do we want to go ahead and just replace it, get a new one on here, or if it go out again, we'll put a new one on here. It doesn't look too bad. All right, I'm gonna let him make a decision. All right, so I spoke with the homeowner. We're gonna go ahead and just replace the motor, he said. Cause he said, he seen when he came out here, it was barely spinning. And he got a home office downstairs working from home, so he don't wanna take a risk of not having any air. So I agree with him, and we're gonna go ahead and get this replaced. Got everything I need. Let's see if this come out easy. Think I got everything I need up in here. Easy money. A lot of people don't like when I talk about that money. Gotta get it, man. Gotta better utilize your skills. Yeah, that's the best portal in the world here. I ain't got time for all that drilling and banging and getting vice grips. This right here got a 99.9% success rate. Never fail. So when you use this though, you want to make sure your screw holes is not lined up with the puller. My first time using it, I put it dead in that keyhole and script it out. Could not get the original key to tighten it. And I had to go buy another blade. And they didn't have any local, so I actually had to travel like 45 miles actually. It probably took me an hour and a half to go get that blade. On my dime. Make that mistake. All right, so this seems like it should be fairly easy. Yeah, ain't nothing to it. Whenever you can hold it with your hand, it's easy, but it's kind of tough, so. Let me get a second set. My videos I was making when I was changing the fan blade out, I didn't cut the tops off to make it shorter so that cap can fit back on there. I've done it 1,000 times, you know, just breaking it off. But sometimes, man, you be running a lot of calls, you don't be thinking right. I forget a lot of stuff sometimes. something so simple like that. But yeah, you can just break them off and put your cap back on now. Yeah, you can hear the bearings in this. So let's check the rotation on this one. I think so. Clockwise is. Clockwise is yellow purple. See that? Clockwise, yellow and purple, yellow and purple. So yeah, you can't break these things off. But on this one, you don't need to. I gotta remember to take that plug out, that rain plug. That's the wrong one. Take this plug out. So I want to kind of line this motor up, blade the same. Let's see, probably about right here. Just gonna eyeball it. All right there. All right. One thing I never did like how they keep feel, but it's going in now. Okay, we all right. Gotta be careful out here. I have been recording some videos. I haven't been uploading a lot lately for the video that I recorded. Something happened with my little memory card on my phone and it's not uploading the videos. But I had one, I don't know if you can see this. I got like probably about 3 stitches. But I was in the attic and I had it on film too. I was in the attic and they had a piece of the hanging scrap, plumber scrap, that was holding the furnace up. And I was replacing 2 actuators, a Honeywell actuator. And my whole arm snapped back and hit that plumber scrap, and I had blood everywhere, meat hanging out and everything. It cut me deep, not long, but it did cut me deep. That's why I say so. So I had to go get that stitched up. That's why I say too, hey. I know a lot of people don't like to talk about money, but you know, we gotta pay hospital bills and everything if we get hurt out here. We don't have no workers comp if you're self-employed. Rotation is correct. It should be. Should follow the schematic, you should be able to take the guesswork out. But since I'm putting the screws back in there. Probably going the wrong way. But we're gonna be optimistic. Almost like putting your torches up before you leak, sir. This right here, I think white is common. If I like that, I might put a spade on here. It might be all right though. Yeah, at least go deep like that. Bow, bow, bow. All right, so we had this looking nice and neat. Take a 7.5 cap. Alright, so we got everything pretty much put back together. We got a 7.5 for the new fan. And we got it wired in. Got it fired up. Yep, we're going the right way, so that's a good deal. That's an 825 RPM. I'm gonna have to start remembering the amp rating on these motors. But these pretty much the only generic motors that I carry. Well, the brand anyway. It may be slightly different from the OEM motor. So the amp is between 1.8 and 2.0. So we under that. 1.5. Okay. Even seem like it moving a little bit more air. Hey, if you think about starting a business, hey, I say go for it. I'm telling you, from my experience, this is the ultimate freedom. It's fun, it's rewarding. So if you're a technician and you got enough experience to get your contractor license, I say go for it, man, because this is beautiful. I pretty much plan my day how I want to plan it, wake up when I want to wake up. I mean, you know, I keep my work ethic now. I'm gonna work. If I work hard for somebody else, I'm gonna work 10 times harder for myself. But man, it just feel good to be free. All right.